retaliate to the Russian spy poisoning. We'll hear from a former British spy boss from Moscow and from a man who calls himself Vladimir Putin's number one enemy. This time yesterday, we were looking forward to the deadline imposed by the British government on the Russian government. It was midnight last night, the deadline for the Kremlin to provide answers over the poisoning of a former Russian spy and his daughter in Salisbury, southern England. As our Moscow correspondent predicted at the time, the Russian government doesn't do deadlines. And so we sailed past midnight, and 12 hours later, the British Prime Minister, Theresa May, today addressed MPs in Westminster. Russia had, she said, treated the use of a military-grade nerve agent in Europe with sarcasm, contempt, and defiance. She said there was no alternative conclusion than that the Russian state was responsible for the attack.
The United Kingdom will now expel 23 Russian diplomats who have been identified as undeclared intelligence officers. They have just 1 week to leave. This will be the single biggest expulsion for over 30 years, and it reflects the fact that this is not the first time that the Russian state has acted against our country. Through these expulsions, we will fundamentally degrade Russian intelligence capability in the UK for years to come. And if they seek to rebuild it, we will prevent them from doing so. Second, we will urgently develop proposals for new legislative powers to harden our defences against all forms of hostile state activity. This will include the addition of a targeted power to detain those suspected of hostile state activity at the UK border. This power is currently only permitted in relation to those suspected of terrorism. And I have asked the Home Secretary to consider whether there is a need for new counter-espionage powers to clamp down on the full spectrum of hostile activities of foreign agents in our country. Mr. Speaker, as I set out on Monday, we will also table a government amendment to the Sanctions Bill to strengthen our powers to impose sanctions in response to the violation of human rights. In doing so, we will play our part in an international effort to punish those responsible for the sorts of abuses suffered by Sergei Magnitsky. And I hope, as with all the measures I am setting out today, that this will command cross-party support. Mr. Speaker, we will also make full use of existing powers to enhance our efforts to monitor and track the intentions of those travelling to the UK who could be engaged in activity that threatens the security of the UK and of our allies. So we will increase checks on private flights, customs and freight. We will freeze Russian state assets wherever we have the evidence that they may be used to threaten the life or property of UK nationals or residents. And led by the National Crime Agency, we will continue to bring all the capabilities of UK law enforcement to bear against serious criminals and corrupt elites. There is no place for these people or their money in our country.
There's an emergency session of the